This is an ordinary wireless router. Such router today is an essential part of the Internet of Things ecosystem, which already includes more than 12 billion devices. Among them are not only personal devices, but also industrial and medical equipment, smart city systems, and much more. Due to the specifics of market requirements, IoT devices have to be as cheap as possible. Thus, IoT devices became extremely vulnerable to cyber threats, more vulnerable than, for example, your laptop. And by hacking corporate wireless routers, the attacker can break into almost anywhere. For example, he can get into computers of accountants, mail servers with correspondence of C-level management, or cloud storage of software developers. But what if a device like this, say an IoT gateway, is installed at an industrial enterprise, and it communicates with systems that directly control the production process? What will happen if this device is hacked? And how to keep cost of protection at an acceptable level? There is an answer to these questions, a new approach to the protection of IT systems, cyber immunity. Let's talk about this in this video. As IoT systems are becoming more sophisticated and widespread, the cyber threats targeted at them are becoming more widespread as well. At the same time, today it's not only a matter of stealing and compromising data, but also a matter of safety of people's lives. For example, in June 2022, hackers attacked a unit controlling the supply of hot metal to the conveyor at an Iranian steel mill. As a result, the unit failed and caused a severe fire. Considering these trends, it became clear that the existing approaches are not enough. This is how the concept of cyber immunity appeared. How can you protect your laptop camera from unauthorized recording? You can detect and block all kinds of spyware, but attackers will come up with new sophisticated methods and you'll have to deal with them in a timely manner as well. Or you can make a shutter that will close the camera and make recording at an appropriate time generally impossible. A similar approach is used in creation of cyber immune systems. In cyber immune approach, we proceed from the fact that in the modern world, everything that can be hacked will be hacked. Therefore, we concentrate our efforts not only on eliminating all known vulnerabilities. We shift the paradigm and concentrate our efforts on building the system's architecture so that the use of vulnerabilities, which always exist, becomes very, very difficult. So difficult that it is just not cost-effective to spread the attack and hack the system. As a result, the system acquires the property of innate protection from both known and completely new types of cyber attack. Thus, for the same amount of money, you can create a system with much better security. But how? To do this, cyber immunity is based on four principles. First, isolation. All components of the cyber immune system are isolated from each other using security domains. If any components of the system is compromised, the attacker will not be able to access other components and spread the attack on them. As a result, not only cyber risk decrease, but also the cost of development, because there is no need to thoroughly check every third-party component of the system. The second principle is interaction control. All interactions between security domains are controlled by a specific module, security monitor. Like a security guard at a private party, it checks whether every interaction is on the whitelist, and if not, it doesn't pass it. It dramatically reduces the attacker's capabilities because all unknown interactions will not pass by default. The third principle is minimalism. Each component of the system, especially critical, should contain as few lines of code as possible, because less code means smaller attack surface and fewer vulnerabilities. It becomes possible due to a microkernel operating system. Such operating system contains hundreds of times fewer lines of code than traditional monolithic kernels, and therefore hundreds of times fewer errors. As a result, whole classes of cyber attacks become generally impossible. The fourth principle is a security development process. When creating a cyberimmune system, developers think about security throughout the entire life cycle, starting from the earliest stages. Even before the architecture is built, we have to formulate specific tasks that the system must perform under any circumstances, even under attack. And then the system is designed so that this is guaranteed. This approach not only allows you to create secure solution, it is also cost-effective, because the cost of fixing vulnerabilities increases as you move through the development lifecycle. It is more beneficial to lay down security at the architecture level. So, the security development process here means that we do not make a system invulnerable in general. It is nearly impossible. We make it invulnerable in context of specific tasks that are set during the development stage. What could be cyberimmune? In general, anything from autonomous cars to industrial systems. Currently, we mostly focus on specialized systems with moderate functionality and low or moderate security requirements. This includes, for example, IoT and industrial IoT devices, various smart city systems, embedded systems, specialized mobile devices. There are already several cyberimmune products, for example, IoT gateways that allow to securely merge OT environment, where there are field devices, sensors, actuators, and machines, with IT environment, where there are various IT systems. The second example is cyberimmune thin client. That is the secure last mile in virtual desktop infrastructure, or VDI, or desktop as a service. And the number of cyberimmune products will grow. In general, cyberimmunity allows us to look at the security of technological products in a brand new way. Due to cyberimmunity, it becomes possible to create devices that are guaranteed to perform their tasks, even if they are targeted by a cyber attack. Thus, the future, which we are so actively moving into, becomes more secure and safe. I'm Alexander Vinyavsky. See you in the next videos about cyber immunity.